y'all, it's Vanessa Love, and this is my channel about mental health field and related topics. So I'm going to explain why this next topic is a mental health issue. So I'm going to be talking about the movie Bullet Train. And I'm talking about it because people who have OCD or anxiety will pick up on things, and where you and I might be like, oh, you know, like, it's just a movie, it's just an action movie, it's not a big deal. Like, it gets into their head. And then, like, they just think about it. And then on this coast, we use the train a lot. So they get on a train, and then they think that this stuff with the bullet train is real and that could totally happen. And they don't know well enough that, like, this isn't how this works. And so, yes, like, it is something that, like, I understand. It is a movie. It is a movie that is not meant to be realistic. It's supposed to be an action film. It's supposed to be funny. Like, it is not, it's not that I don't have a sense of humor. It's that I just want to make sure that people understand the reality of the situation and not about, like, just go along their day until they have to take a train and then they freak out. So, all right. There's so many things about the trains too, where it's like Japan is able to have, like, this infrastructure because it, like, they put that infrastructure in the 1960s, after they were recovering from the war. So we haven't been lucky enough to be able to spend that way, unfortunately, in the United States. Also, we have, like, so many bureaucrats that are kind of in the way. So, like, it's a lot of different things. Like, it's never just one simple thing. I can say that by that it's multi-millions to create an infrastructure kind of like this. And it's like, even if you were able to do it, which some of the trains in the United States are able to get up to, like, I think 70 miles an hour, it's only when there's not residential, like, in non-residential areas. So, like, this populated area in New York and Connecticut and Boston or Massachusetts, you're just not going to have a lot of places where you're able to be away from residential areas that would make you go fast or use any of this, especially, like, with all of the issues that do come about with using bullet trains, such as, like, the noise and the suction, I guess. It's a very powerful train. People have to really stand back, and they have to watch when they go through tubes, through tunnels and stuff. It's a very interesting thing. So I did look that up, but also, like, I have a family member who works in trains, so, like, some of this information is just because I could talk to them about the funniness of this movie. So some of this is personal, I guess, conversation. The other thing is that, there's been, what is that called? So Stanford has three bridges that have been there since the 1850s, or not even 1950s, 1850s, 1860s, 1800s. The infrastructure is still the same. So they were able to get one of the bridges, I said there were three, one of the bridges that goes over some of the main roads, to be updated fairly recently, and they, I think it was a multi-million dollar thing. So they don't know when the other two might be updated, because they just don't know when the state will have that money. They are looking into a couple of other places to start installing infrastructure. I just saw something today about the New Haven having, like, a little bit of, like, a more of a cohesive, you know, rail, I guess, but also they've had rail before, so maybe they're kind of banking on, like, the previous rail. And then New London area, they had a rail road that went from, like, New London, Norwich to Massachusetts, just over the border, and, like, a lot of it has actually been turned into parks. So there is some infrastructure there that they may be revitalizing, probably moving around those parts that were turned into parks. Fun stuff. So there might be more projects. There's definitely been some surveys, there's been some updates, but, like, as far as you know, like, people getting you know, to and from on trains as of yet, in some of those places, not necessarily. So, yes, I do know some of this stuff because of conversations, because of observations. So early on in the movie, they talk about how the bullet train stops for a minute and at each station, which is about true. Unless you have a disability and you need help getting from like the train to the station or the next thing. Japan is pretty organized. The United States, not so much. You would basically like make sure that the conductors know that you need red cab service, and hopefully red cab is available at that station. That red cab service would be available at that station and be able to help you off. Sometimes there's a little bit of a dispute between whether or not someone's, like their, what their job is entirely. Like also as far as like some of the Metro North, like Amtrak, they usually need like a plate to get like wheelchairs over the gap. Especially with the diesel engine trains, not necessarily the electric trains, depending. And so like there would still need to be a push over. So yeah, that's like so that would take longer at a station. It should be a minute, but like for some things it might not be. Japan has reported that like in 2019 that there were only a 13-second delay, so like on their trains, like average. So I guess there's something to that. I don't, it's one of those things where I'm like, is that one of those things where they kind of created something that was like, oh, as long as you get to the end at the right time, then we won't like count how many times you were late at the other stations if you can make up for the time? Fun, no. Okay. So, one of the other things that happened is that throughout the movie, there just starts to become less and less people on the train until it's only the assassins on the train, which I'm like, okay, but wasn't this an overnight train? How did everyone get off this train? Where did everyone get off this train? Like, that's a, such a weird thing. And like, if you only had five passengers, like, that seems like you don't need that train. So they might actually change the schedule so that that wouldn't happen again, So sometimes some of these characters go into cars that are empty, which I'm like, that just doesn't happen on trains, first of all. Second of all, it's like there's like a stock room that was available on the train, which I'm like, there's a stock room on a train? Okay, I haven't been on long-term train. I don't think so. But okay, there's gonna be someone like standing there and monitoring that. Like that's they just don't. Like go, oh, okay, we have a food cart. Okay, now we're just gonna go. Like usually someone's hanging out around there because people would just take stuff. Like what do you mean? Like that there's just a whole room filled with like all of the stuff, and it's available, and people are doing whatever weirdness they're gonna do to it, or they're taking it. Like that's so weird. The other thing is that the cafe car, like the little bar area, is like. Like no one's monitoring that, and that's another place where they definitely do that. Like even if it's closed, there is someone standing nearby. They have on Amtrak specifically what they call like service agents, and like they are on the train to work like on like at the cafe car. If they're not going to be in the cafe, like if the cafe car isn't open, people are still there, first of all. Second of all, like the person, the service agent is still there. So like no. Yeah, I thought that was hilarious. So in one scene, someone busts open the door and of course, oh, it's going so fast, and then they have to like go and get back into the train. No train is operating, especially not that fast, with a door open. Like, immediately stop. Like, there is the, they have sensors on all of those things. They have cameras on all of those things. I do not expect that this is going to be any different for any other place. Like, that's a weird thing. Like, nope, train stop. There's no way that they would let someone in, like, with the Japanese. Trains the way that they are not letting someone on that train without a ticket. Like, that is weird that they were just like, oh, he just walked away. Like, that, no. Like, they're not just gonna be like, oh, okay, we'll get to you later. Like, and then not come around again. Like, no, you need to pay for your ticket. They will remember your face, they will come back. I've like, this is very easy. This is like almost like Train Conductor 101. Like, you gotta know that. Also, Train Conductor 101, no one's gonna be left on the train dead. Like, do you understand? Like, if they see something that's like just a little off, they're gonna be like, first of all, they have to walk the train, okay? They have to make sure everyone's safe. That's part of safety, right? So you're telling me that like there were two people dead on the train and no one knew? You're telling me that there was another two people, a person and another person in the bathroom and like both dying and the conductors just let the bathroom be shut? No. Oh my God, no. Oh my God, no. Like, oh my God. Just no. Mm-mm. They're not leaving people. They're not leaving people just dead, hanging out. Like, you can make them look like they're not dead. You can tell when people aren't sleeping, you know? Like, yeah. In one scene, Ladybug blocks a door. Oh my God, no way. No way is that happening on any train. Oh my God, that is not happening. You are not. First of all, there are gonna be people up and about anyway. Like, even if it's an overnight train and everyone's like gonna settle in. No, there's gonna be people up and about like all the time. Like, there's no way that like, I mean, it's all set up in that way anyway to like make the person go out and, you know, whatever. But like, you're not closing it and then the one person that you need to open it opens it. Like, that's just, it's not. Like, as soon as you start doing that stuff, people will be like, why are you touching my stuff? What are you doing? What is this? Like, oh my God, they'd have so much. They'd have so much. Also, usually your suitcases are within your sight. They are not kept out and in a vestibule somewhere. Like, that's just such a weird concept to be like, okay, yeah, so here's your bags. Here's the door. Go find a seat. Like, there's overhead. There's usually something like that you can see where your suitcases are. Like, it's like, I don't, that was such a bizarre concept to me. I was like, I don't think so. Okay. I understand it's an action movie. I totally get it. No one is punching a windshield in a bullet train and getting through. No one is punching a windshield in a bullet train and getting through, okay? 'Cause like, do you know what that would mean? That would mean that any like chicken would just break that window all the time. That's like, apparently there are warnings on like a lot of these things that say don't use like an axe or a bat or whatever in case of emergency because it's just gonna like tap back and hit you in the face. Like, these windshields are very, very tough because unfortunately they do have to stand up to more pressure than like I'm like a carrot, a chicken. You know, like sometimes they might accidentally hit a deer while you're on the train. So I'm like, they have to kind of hold up to a lot of things, including hitting a deer. But like also they monitor the track so like they know like where things are, what's going on, you know? So you're not punching through. You're not punching through. No one is using a gun on a train, and no one, and that train isn't stopping. And like, if they are not stopping, they're waiting till the next station to get that person off the train. Like, if like the conductors have to, you know, restrain the person, you know, they'll do it. And like, off at the next, please, we'll meet you at the next station because it's just a phone call away. It is not a problem. And like, the MTA has their own police at a particular station, so you are either dealing with the city police or you're dealing with the MTA police. So like, I would imagine that like that Japan would be the same. Oh, there was also another part of this that I was like, this is so, yeah, it was the people like not being on the train. I'm like, what are you guys doing? Like, where did everyone go? Yeah, that's not like a thing that happens. Okay. So two trains, so this is what my family member told me, two trains on like a bullet train track cannot collide because of the magnets. They are always opposing, and so like they couldn't be on the same track because one's going one way and the other one's going the other way. So like the polarity in the magnets wouldn't allow for them to hit each other. Also, if there was two trains on one track, again, tracks are monitored, so you would just like shut down one or the other train, and they do have this capacity. There's really like no way to like go over that. The train will just shut down. Like that's the modern trains, that's what they do. They just nope, done. You're not doing it. Yeah, that's one of those things where I'm like, there's speed restrictions. Like, oh yeah, that was one of the other things I was gonna say. So like this guy gets into the like basically the engineer's seat and is trying to figure out how to make the train go. And like first there's a lot of like contact between like stations and like station supervision places. I don't know entirely what that would be called, but like there are people who are monitoring the tracks and at certain points, and so like you would always be in contact with them. So you wouldn't just be like on a track going as fast as you can without stopping, without any breaks, and that would be perfectly fine. You can't actually go as fast as like you think you can on the train. Like you can't just like push a lever and just be like, oh, now I'm going this top speed. Nope. Again, monitored. They'll turn that off. They'll be like, first of all, you're not supposed to be on that track, so we're gonna do a track change. Once you get to that connection, we're gonna stop the other train before they get to that connection, so you're not gonna be on the same track. And also speed restriction and penalty. So, no. No. You are not getting up there and just fiddling around and doing it. Like this is not. And sometimes like in some trains the engineer sits so separate from where the train actually like goes that like or like is connected that like they have to get out of the driver's seat basically. Like climb down, go onto the tracks, then climb up, go to the other side, you know, if there's like some if they have to switch directions or something, which I've seen before. And then, you know, like they can't just like open a door and get right back in. Like that's not how that works. They're actually separated. So don't think that you can just go in and like be like, oh, I could just press buttons and things and like everything's gonna work. Like, nope. Also, I believe that on some trains, like everyone works together to kind of like control trains. So like you can definitely stop trains if like your conductors are also like, you know, I think it depends. But I could be totally wrong about that. Also with the way that bullet trains are made, this is from my family member. Like if they go off the rail, because I know at the ending, like I know, spoiler alert, that like the train just like falls off the track and then just keeps going, which I'm like, okay, first of all, that wouldn't have just happened. Like you're not taking something that heavy and just like flinging it or down a hill and it's just gonna go that far. Like in some states, yeah, probably maybe, but like especially with the bullet train, you're not going to fall off and then continue like going for miles and miles and end up in the middle of town. No. What would happen most likely is it becomes demagnetized and then it like I think that there's something like underneath that's like kind of like this, so like it would just sink. So you wouldn't even go anywhere. But on top of that, if it was gonna topple over, it would just kind of like just topple over a little bit. Like it wouldn't just slide around. And like because It wouldn't just slide around. Like, that's just not, it's just not the way it works. So yes, again, I understand that this is an action movie. It is not supposed to be realistic. It is supposed to be funny. It's supposed to be off the wall. However, people get anxiety, and I would rather over-explain something than not explain why that's not like true to reality, you know? And like, I don't want people to have anxiety. And like, I know, like, when I was a kid, like, some of that stuff, like, it would scare me, and then I probably like wouldn't want to ride the train. You know, I'd be like, but what if we hit another train? Because that always happens in movies. And it's like, let me tell you how switches work and how everyone monitors like the, you know, switches and everything, like, and knows that when people are on the tracks, and you know, that type of stuff. Like, no, they're monitored. That's how that goes. It's monitored. I've been on a train when they've been like, oh, there's a bunch of birds on the track ahead. Or, you know, there's like people off to the side. We saw them earlier. You know, like, or, you know, we told people to get off the tracks, like, you know, 2 miles ahead. They know. They know. So yeah, just like I would need that reassurance, so I want other people to have that reassurance. Well, I hope that was helpful for you, and I will talk with you at some other point. Thanks for liking, subscribing, and commenting. And yeah, I'll talk to you soon. All right, bye.